What we're gonna do right here is go back. Way back. Back into time.
Thank you very kindly. Mr. Chairman, members of this very fine organization, National Association of Radio Announcers, distinguished dais guests, ladies and gentlemen, I need not pause to say how very delighted I am to be here this evening and to share with you in your annual convention. I valued a special opportunity to address you this evening, for in my years of struggle, both north and south, I have come to appreciate the role which the radio announcer plays in the life of our people. For better or for worse, you are opinion makers in the community. And it is important that you remain aware of the power which is potential in your vocation. The masses are almost totally dependent on radio as their means of relating to the society at large. They do not read newspapers. Television speaks not to their needs, but to upper middle class America. One need only recall the Watts tragedy and the quick adoption of the Burn, Baby Burn slogan to influence of the radio announcer on the community. But while the establishment was quick to blame the tragedy of Watts, most unjustly, on the slogan of Magnificent Montague, it has not been ready to acknowledge all of the positive features which grow out of your contribution to the community. No one knows the importance of Paul White in the massive nonviolent demonstrations of the youth of Birmingham in 1963. Are the funds raised by Purvis Spann for the Mississippi Summer Project of 1964? Are the consistent fundraising and voter education done for the Southern Christian Leadership Conference and the Civil Rights Movement by Georgia Wood, my good friend of Philadelphia? Tonight I want to say thank you, not just to these few, but to all of you who have given leadership to our people in thousands of unknown and unsung ways. We would certainly not have come so far without your support. And in a real sense, you have paved the way for social and political change by creating a powerful cultural bridge between black and white. School integration is much easier now that they share a common music, a common language, and enjoy the same dances. You introduced youth to that music and created the language of soul and promoted the dance which now sweeps across race, class, and nation. It is quite amazing to me to hear the joyful rhythms which I found time to enjoy as a youth here in Atlanta years ago, coming back across the Atlantic with an English accent, are to see the Senator Javits and the Senator Kennedy's lost in the dances which we created. Yes, you have taken the power which old Sam had buried deep in his soul and throughout amazing technology performed a cultural conquest that surpasses even Alexander the Great and the culture of classical Greece. But my brothers and my sisters, we're only beginning. We still have a long, long way to go.
You must address yourself to these problems. These are the problems you live with daily. They don't want your old hard heads. They want the young mind. 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 They want the young
mind. This love is a strange love. That it can live by love.
Look at MS.com and you see the seven top executives of MS Communication. They are all white men over the age of 50.
Right.
Programming poison to our children. As a new mother with a two-month-old, I refuse to let these companies, these corporations, call my daughter a bitch, a hoe, a nigger. It's over. It's not about free speech. It's about your peddling drugs into the mind of our community. What you do is addicting our children to violence.
Can you get down? Can you talk trash? Can you get funky? Can you get nasty? You got the job. Now look, brother, that's the basis upon which they hire you. And do you know why? White folks is into the business of mind control. Don't you know why black people are not productive? It's because their minds are being controlled and you are the agent that they're using. You in black music. Listen to me, brother. Because I'm warning you today, but tomorrow your head is going to roll.
If you look at BET and MTV owned by the Viacom network, they extend the teenage years to 31. And it is nothing more foul than when you see that an older cat is mixing their lifestyle with somebody 12 and 13. Ain't nobody hardly in all these control areas, they don't talk, forget about high schools. You gotta see what's going on in 7th grade, 6th grade, and 5th grade. And I tell 12th graders, 11th graders, don't you got a little brother or sister that think they grown? They say, uh-huh. So there's a problem with trickle down. The older, the 30-year-old is afraid to talk to the 20-year-old. The 20-year-old afraid to talk, oh man, I can't talk, they little wild. The 14-year-olds is wild. The 14-year-old, they ain't even talking to the 10-year-old anymore. And this comes from not owning your word. And this comes from not owning your word.
Entertainers, we dominate the field of entertainment, but we don't control the field of entertainment. And people, entertainers, are used as weapons against us. They are used as political tools against black people. The whole movement is in danger of being co-opted by the politicians of the white power structure. They recognize that if they can get black people thinking culturally, they don't have to worry about them moving politically.
I still have a dream. My poor little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream.
Speaking truth to power in times of turmoil. It's Breakdown FM. Radio, radio, radio.
radio with the meaning.
It's all good.